up across from the Malabar Farm Inn restaurant. We're going to have staff fishing up there today from 11 to 2. I hope to see lots of kids up in that area catching fish. It's been restocked. That pond has been renovated with the help of Bob Cumbo and his crews. They're absolutely beautiful. And I don't think that there's been a day that's passed since we finished that work up there that I haven't seen people fishing and enjoying that pond. It's also handicap accessible, which makes it another unique feature here to Malabar Farms. So we highly encourage folks to go up there, enjoy the resources that we have, and take that in. And lastly, the farm as a whole. I'm really passionate about agriculture. And I certainly appreciate all the support that we've got here at Malabar Farm. I certainly need to make another group of people known here today. It takes a lot of vision and leadership to accomplish what you see here today. And I can tell you that the administration that we have right now certainly has vision and leadership. Without Director Zeringer's leadership, a lot of this certainly would not have happened. He's a very successful farmer in his own right. He's received lots of environmental accolades for the work that he's done on his own home farm. We're very fortunate to have a person like him at the helm. So certainly as you folks walk around today and you enjoy Malabar Farm State Park, take a moment to thank this administration for all of the work that they've done. As I look out here at the crowd, I've got to thank some other folks. Since I came on board basically about 10 months ago, it's been less than a year I've been here. I've had nothing but support from the Chief of Parks, Chief Glenn Cobb, standing out here today. He's a tremendous individual and is always a phone call away and always willing to lend support however we need it. He is a great asset to Ohio State Parks and a special friend of Malabar Farms here. Doug Lyons, who's our Northeast District Manager, he oversees Malabar and everybody basically north and east of here. He does a tremendous job. 2 weeks ago, as we were nearing some of the end of this renovation, he came in and said, let's get more folks down here. Let's make sure that this really is the Super Bowl of the year here for Ohio State Parks. He brought more folks in down here, lended his guidance and leadership, and really brought this place to life and lended us a great hand this week. Bob Cumbo and his crew, you've heard that name a lot. He's been here every step of the way with me on this project. So he certainly needs a big pat on the back. Gary Obermiller, he's been here every step of the way with us also. The Malabar Farm Foundation, what a great partnership we have going with those folks. They're always willing to jump in, be a part of the success in any way possible. And so it is a great, great partnership. And it's super when Ohio State Parks and Ohio State government can get together with citizens of Ohio to make great things like this happen. You know, this is a day that we really need to cherish because it's the best of what we have to offer, not only within ODNR and state government, but also with our Ohio citizens. So thank you all for coming out and being a part of this day with us. Just a few other folks that I'm going to do a quick mention here with. On the back of your programs, there are some individuals that have really lent a great amount of support through all of this. Dr. Robert Linda Berry, I'm surprised they're here because I've worked them so much over the last week, but they've still got smiles on their faces, and I greatly appreciate that. Dr. Winfield Meek. As we were doing a lot of the stonework that you see around here, Dr. Meek was kind enough to give us a call and say, I've got some stone that you might be interested in. It's a period, and I think it'll look great. He was wrong. It doesn't look great. It looks amazing as you look around here. So I appreciate your charitable donation to us, Doctor. Greg McNeely, you heard earlier, he's been down here, and he's told me a lot of stories of when he was a kid riding his bike down around through Malabar Farms and how it's never looked this good. Justin Murata with Possum Run Greenhouse, he's absolutely bent over backwards to make this greenhouse look as beautiful as it does, and also our terrace gardens. Malabar Farm Foundation, again, a great partnership. Jim Huffman and the Richland County Master Gardeners, he's been here every step of the way helping us out. And really, those folks are great. And Jim has told me that they're looking forward to coming and helping us out with these gardens to keep things looking beautiful. And Willowdale Nursery, again, I've told you about the heritage and history with those folks. So with that, I'm going to wrap this up. If I could get the director to step up here with me real quick. We're going to signal the cannon here this morning, and I want you to be the one that gives that sign.
What sign would that be? Fire the cannon!
Come in and join us inside for the short reception. Thank you all for joining us. Enjoy the weekend. Enjoy Malabar Farms. Yay!